Good luck, Desmond.
These are troubled times. The already uneasy alliance between the Crown and its subjects frays. And behind them both, the Templars plot, pulling strings and moving pieces. History dictates they seek order through control. But how will they effect it here? Who supports them? And what conspiracies have they already spun? All these things I must determine. For only by knowing my enemy can I hope to stop them.
Connor, spare a moment.
Of course.
Have a look.
What is it?
A Xingbao, or rope dart, if you prefer. One of the many plans given to us by Xiao Yun to...
Sorry.
We'll have to work on this.
Ganondogo.
Yes, my friend.
What brings you here? Is the village all right?
For now.
What do you mean? What has happened?
Men came, claiming we had to leave. They said that the land was being sold, and that the Confederacy had consented. We sent an envoy, but they would not listen.
You must refuse!
We cannot oppose the Sachem, but you're right as well. We cannot give up our home.
Do you have a name? Do you know who is responsible?
He's called William Johnson.
Where is Johnson now?
In Boston, making preparations for the sale.
Sale? This is theft!
Connor, take care. These men are powerful.
What would you have me do? I made a promise to my people.
If you insist upon this course of action, seek out Sam Adams in Boston. He'll be able to help. What have you done?
When my people go to war, a hatchet is buried into a post to signify its start. When the threat is ended, the hatchet is removed.
You could have used a tree.
Sanctions and demonstrations won't suffice, Sam. We need to act, and I'm talking about more than a sternly worded letter.
I sympathize with your frustrations, gentlemen. But surely you can understand my reluctance to kick the hornet's nest.
The Tories think no matter what they do, might as well make it count.
Thank you.
Ah, Connor. Hello again. What brings you to Boston?
You.
Would you excuse us, fellows? Thank you. That conversation was about to turn unpleasant. Now, what can I do for you?
I was hoping you could help me locate William Johnson.
Of course. I'm headed to a meeting with some men who should be able to help. Why don't you come along? Ah, it's good to see the people finally taking a stand against injustice.
Says the man who owns a slave.
Ooh, sorry? I practice what I preach, my friend. She's not a slave, but a freed woman, at least on paper. Men's minds are not so easily turned. It's a tragedy that for all our progress, still we cling to such barbarism.
Then speak out against it.
We must focus first on defending our rights. When this is done, we'll have the luxury of addressing these other matters.
You speak as though your condition is equal to that of the slaves. It is not.
Tell that to my neighbor who was compelled to quarter British troops, or to my friend whose store was closed because he displeased the crown. The people here are no freer than Surrey.
You offer excuses instead of solutions. All people should be equal, and not in terms.
It's in terms or not at all. We must compromise, Connor, however painful that may be. Try and solve all the world's problems at the same time, and you'll wind up solving none at all.
Not so much the amount. 3 pence a pound is hardly burdensome, but...
Hey! It's my home, no matter what you thieves called taxmen say. If the gumps in Parliament who want to take my property, you tell them to sail across the pond and take it themselves.
It's not open for discussion now. Open this door or these men will break it down. Ah!
The bullocks, we're coming in.
Ah! Oh. I trust the mounting evidence is proof enough, Connor.
Continue on. I shall meet you at our destination.
Justice for once. I dare the governor to send more.
You all right?
I'm fine. It's not my first dance. For all their teeth and claws, these little foxes, they fight like puppies. Thank you, my friend. I'd buy you an ale, but I'm expected somewhere else.
Connor, I'd like you to meet some like-minded friends. The owner of this fine establishment, William Molyneux, and the manager and chef of his newest venture, Stefan Chaffaut.
Ah, Connor and I just had a ball with some red coats enforcing some taxmen outside my home.
The collectors grow bolder and more forceful. Something we must address, Samuel.
Then let us raise a banner. Something to let the people know that they are not alone. The docks are an angry place of late. Protesters picketing the latest shipments of British tea. The eyes of the city are upon that stage.
A Bostonian without his tea is a dangerous beast.
William Johnson is smuggling the tea off the ships. One of his men tried to sell me this. A sample of what I refused. But it's from those ships. No mistaking the stamp. He's charging a king's ransom. Must be he's making a mint off those who buy it.
Where is he now?
I've never met the man.
May I ask why you seek him, Connor?
He intends to purchase the land upon which my village stands, without the consent of my people.
No doubt the revenue from his little smuggling endeavor is financing the acquisition. A tax enforced on tea grants a boon to smugglers. I'll wager the same men who levy the taxes are selling the tea. A stage requires a spectacle, and I may know the play. Connor. Head back to the docks and see to the destruction of the tea. If you should need us, return here.
Ah! Pardon me.
Oh, come on, mate.
Hello, Connor. That tea is being illegally smuggled all around Boston by Johnson's men. If you see any crates in transit, perhaps you could put a stop to the delivery. And those moody tax collectors are still at it. They could use a lesson or two, huh?
honorable gentlemen claim it is not so much the amount. 3 pence a pound is hardly burdensome, but it has been imposed without our counsel, rendering us mere spectators of our own commerce.
The deadline to unload the tea will soon arrive, and I say
we must not.
Thank you.
Shinies in the field.